Now, if we draw all these parameters in a velocity time curve for this particle, then we can easily obtain it using the curve which we are going to discuss now. Just see, the particle was shown at t equal to 0 with some velocity u. For my convenience, I am taking upward direction to be positive and downward direction to be negative. Then initially as velocity u was vertically upward, so I have taken it on the positive v axis. Here particle's initial velocity was u. As acceleration during upward motion was negative, so particle's velocity continuously goes on decreasing. As per the condition where acceleration is constant, no doubt slope of the velocity time curve which gives us acceleration was constant but negative, so velocity time curve here will be a straight line with negative slope. Here I have drawn this line with some negative slope. You can achieve that slope of the curve here is negative. As I have taken positive direction to be vertically upward and downward direction to be negative, so while going in upward direction, particle's velocity was positive. When it reaches at its maximum height, its velocity becomes zero. So at this time ta, starting from t equal to 0 to this time ta, till which it ascends in its path from the ground, so its velocity for the entire time during this period is positive. When it reaches at its maximum height, its velocity becomes zero for a moment, and after that it starts falling downward. As downward is negative direction, so I have taken further velocities to be negative because it is moving vertically downward. As acceleration is constant throughout the motion, which is vertically downward, so I have not changed the slope of the line. Just velocity becomes negative in this period, and at time td, when it returns back to its initial point from where it was thrown, then its velocity again becomes u, the same as velocity of projection in magnitude but negative in direction, because now it is moving vertically downward. So what we achieve here, that first particle moves in forward direction till its velocity becomes zero. When its velocity becomes zero, then it is at its highest point. After that, it starts falling down, and in the same time interval in which it reaches from ground to that highest point, it again falls till the same point from where it was thrown in the same time interval, provided that other dissipative effect like friction of air or air resistance or viscous force of air has been neglected. If those effects are neglected, then surely particles take same time to reach at the maximum height and to come back from maximum height to its point of projection again. So this is the velocity time curve for the particle, and we can easily say that here ratio of these two lengths on velocity axis and on time axis, it will be the magnitude of acceleration. Means from 0 to u, this length on the velocity axis is u, and this length on the time axis is equal to ta. So we can write u upon ta to be magnitude of acceleration. And as we know, here acceleration is acceleration due to gravity. We may take it to be 9.8 meter per second square. So this magnitude of acceleration is equal to the length on this velocity axis upon the length on this time axis when its velocity becomes zero. Right. Here magnitude of the slope gives magnitude of the acceleration. And if we want to find the velocity, if we want to find acceleration in vector form with sign, then we can find it by using acceleration equal to change in velocity upon time taken. If we talk about change in velocity, then it can be written as final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. So here on this time axis, if we talk about the time ta, when it reaches at its highest point, its velocity becomes zero. So here in this time interval 0 to ta, velocity of the particle becomes zero minus, at the time of projection velocity was u, so 0 minus u is the change in velocity, and time obviously ta minus 0, which is the time interval till reaching from the ground to that maximum height. So acceleration here is minus u upon ta, means minus 9.8 meter per second square. This is our observation about the acceleration, which is negative for this velocity. So what we can get from here is this information. Now let us consider a particular question, for example, in which we are going to utilize this type of curve to get the answers. Just see the example. A particle has initial velocity 9 meter per second due east and acceleration 2 meter per second square due west. Note that here initial velocity and acceleration of the particle are in opposite direction. One is at east and other is at west side. Now what we have to do is we have to find distance traveled during 5th second of its motion. Now some questions arises here. First, equations of motion which we have got as the three basic equations, v equal to u plus at, s equal to ut plus half at square, and v square equal to u square plus twice as. These three equations are used to relate displacement, velocity, acceleration and time for the motion. Now if we are talking about the distance traveled, then distance traveled will be equal to displacement only if particle do not change its direction of motion. Direction of motion can only be changed if velocity and acceleration are in opposite directions. Here, as initial velocity is due east and acceleration is due west, so obviously there will be a time its velocity becomes zero, and after that, because acceleration is continuously acting, then particle starts moving in opposite direction. In that case, if we are talking this distance traveled in a particular second, then at least in that period of motion, particle's velocity must not change its direction. If it changes its direction, then any result obtained from these equations of kinematics will give us the displacement, and obviously in that case displacement will not be equal to distance traveled. So what we do here, we just try to solve this question using velocity time graph, because when we use velocity time graph, we find a clear cut idea about the positive and negative velocities. So the method of graphical analysis will give us a clear cut idea about this question and obviously about the distance travel. What we will do, if we get displacement negative in a particular time period, then by taking it as magnitude only without sign, we can say that particle is moving along a straight line, so the magnitude of displacement will give us distance. See, the informations which are given to us is particle's initial velocity is 9 meter per second and acceleration of the particle is 2 meter per second square but in opposite direction. For the simplicity, I am noting here the directions. East is taken as positive and west is taken as negative. So if we draw the velocity time curve for this particular situation, then what type of graph we obtain? Just see here. Here on the x-axis of the xy coordinate system, I am taking time t, and on the y-axis I am taking velocity v of the particle, and velocity is taken positive along the positive y direction. Just see, for the particle, as initial velocity is 9 meter per second, acceleration is negative, so we obtain the velocity time graph as a straight line with negative slope. It is the time at which its velocity becomes zero. Just see here, as particle starts with 9 meter per second, so it is its initial velocity, which is at t equal to 0. As acceleration means the slope of this line is minus 2. This is 9, so this must be 4.5 seconds. Means at t equal to 4.5 seconds, its velocity becomes 0. And we are talking about the distance traveled during 5th second, which comes between 4 seconds to 5 seconds. We know that area under velocity graph gives us displacement. So, if we mark velocity corresponding to t equal to 4, we can say that this is half second and acceleration has the magnitude 2. So, no doubt this velocity v must be 1 meter per second, double of this time interval. Obviously, at the negative side of the velocity time curve, at t equal to 5, we get the same velocity but in opposite direction, so it is minus 1 meter per second. Now, what we have to get is just to get the area under this velocity time graph. Area between 4 to 4.5 seconds, it gives us the positive displacement, and this displacement is plus half into base into height, which is equal to 0.25 meter. I have done it using half into base into height because the velocity time curve here is a triangle. So, area of triangle, half into base into height. Base, we have taken the time interval, which is half second between 4 to 4.5 second, and velocity at 4 second is 1 meter per second, and velocity at the 4.5 second is 0. So, displacement between 4 to 4.5 second is this much, means 0.25 meter, which is positive displacement. But on the other hand, during the time interval 4.5 to 5 seconds, the area under velocity time graph gives us the same magnitude of displacement but negative, means 0.25 meter but in negative direction. Now, if we talk about the displacement during 5th second, then no doubt it is equal to plus 0.25 plus negative of 0.25 meter, means 0 meter. But if we want to find the distance traveled, then distance traveled during the 5th second, it is equal to magnitude of displacement between 4 to 4.5 second, which is 0.25, and again between 4.5 to 5 second, it is minus 0.25 meter, but the magnitude is only 0.25. So, the distance traveled by the particle going along a straight line, it becomes 0.5 meter, and this is our final answer. What this answer gives us, that we can get distance traveled for a particle moving along a straight line by the velocity time graph and its area without sign. But if we want to get displacement of the particle, then we must take area of velocity time graph, but with sign. So this is our answer for this particular question. And obviously you have seen here how we get it. We can use this curve or this method to find the distance and displacement traveled both for a particle.